Well, good morning, and thank you all for being here this morning. It's such a thrill to see such a strong turnout again this morning for one of our March On events. These events we host monthly to give the public a little bit of an update on something that's going on in and across the community. And we do a lot of listening across the community to find out what subjects the public wants to hear about. And we've heard that the West Henderson area and some of the things that are going on in West Henderson were an important priority for our community, so we're making sure to give you that update today. So we're thrilled to have all of you here, and just so that you know, making sure that we get the message out to the public is very important to us. So one of the things that we do is we actually have staff here video recording this event, and that information will be posted to the City of Henderson website so that the public can also know more. Those that can't attend and aren't able to attend, that information is available to them as well going forward. So we're thrilled to have you here for this March On event, and it's important for us to share in a meaningful way what's going on in our community. Before I go further, I did want to acknowledge and recognize some important folks who are in the room. We have some of the best employees, I think, in the state, if not the country. We have a premier city, great quality of life. We're regularly receiving awards for the great work that's being done in our community, and it's due in large part to the great city employees that we have here. So I'd like to acknowledge that our city manager is here, Richard Derrick. And our we have two of our assistant city managers here, Stephanie Garcia-Voss and Rob Herr. We have Ken Chappa, who's the Acting Director of Economic Development. We have Sean White, who's our Fire Chief. Scott Vivier, who's our Assistant, our Deputy Fire Chief. And we have our Acting Deputy Chief from the Police Department, Dave Burns. We have Kyle Akamura with us, who's the Deputy Director of our Utility Services Department. So when you turn on the water or flush your toilet, thank you, you guys. We appreciate it. Michael Tassie is here from Community Development. He'll be speaking shortly. From our Parks and Recreation Department, and we've got great facilities across Henderson, and you're going to hear more about them, especially in West Henderson. We have Sherry Ferguson and Jane Mazurkowitz from the department over in the corner. And we have our Public Works Director and Assistant Director, Ed McGuire and Alyssa Rodriguez. We also have Liz Baldazon, who chairs our Senior Citizen Advisory Board, so we appreciate your being here, Liz. And we have a number of groups who have tables here, and we're going to be hearing, or you'll have an opportunity to visit their tables and to learn a little bit more about what their departments are working on, and they include the City Clerk's Office, the Fire and Emergency Management, and the Henderson Police Department. So thank you all for being here, and I hope you'll, after we do the presentations, we're going to be hearing from three speakers, and after we hear from them, we'll open it up to questions and answers on the topics that they discussed in West Henderson, and then we'd like to invite you and encourage you to visit the tables and learn a little bit more about what's going on in the city of Henderson as well. So thank you to all of you for your dedication and hard work at the city of Henderson. And to the community members who showed up, we appreciate your involvement as well. So Henderson is regularly recognized as one of the great places to live, work, and play in America. And this is one of the fastest growing cities in the country. In fact, I was in a meeting in New York last week, and we were talking about how our population is about 314,000. Just 2 years ago, our population was 277,000. So these amazing employees at the City of Henderson are managing that growth responsibly, making sure that we have our toilets flush, our water is working, our streets are working for our public, and our parks are doing well. In fact, I think we have a goal in the City of Henderson to have a park or a trail within a 10-minute walk of every home in our community. And that's quality of life, our commitment to quality of life for our residents going forward. So today's program, we're going to be hearing about the things that are going on in the West Henderson area. And our first speaker will be Michael Tassie, who's our Community Development and Services Director, who's going to give us an overview of this dynamic area in our community. Then we're going to be hearing from Amy Wojcik from our Parks and Recreation Department. She's our park planner. And we're going to hear about some of the wonderful things happening there. And then after that, we're going to be hearing from Tom Davies, who's our city engineer, who's going to talk about our trails and infrastructure and some of the investments that are being made in the West Henderson area. So with that, I'd like to invite Michael Tassie to the podium. Thank you.
Well, good morning. Can everybody hear me back there? All right, very good. Thank you, Mayor. My name is Michael Tassie. I'm the Director of Community Development and Services. I've been with the city of Henderson for 24 years. I grew up in the city of Henderson. I moved there from Las Vegas when I was six. So as you can imagine, I've seen a lot of growth in my time here as a resident and as an employee for this great city. So as the mayor said, I'm gonna give you some context about what is involved in West Henderson, what is West Henderson. And then we have a couple of our superstars here, Amy and Tom from Parks and Public Works, who will get up and talk about parks and roadways. And then I'll get back up and I'm gonna run through all of the proposed developments that we have happening in West Henderson. So that's gonna, we have about 80 slides. So if you hold your questions till afterwards, we'll get through them as quickly as possible. And if you can't hear me, give me the signal and I'll start speaking up louder. So let's get started. So I just wanna give you some context, and the gray's not showing up very well, but that essentially is the city of Henderson, and that blue outline is what we call West Henderson. Which is the area that is essentially to the west of both Seven Hills and Anthem. It includes Inspirata, all the way out to the I-15 where the M Resort sits right now. So that is our West Henderson area. That's the area we'll be talking about today. This slide just shows the master planned roadways that we have in Henderson. When you have to plan for a community, the infrastructure and how you get around is vital. And so when we talk about master planning, just generally speaking, but in West Henderson, the roadways are a vital aspect of that. And Tom will talk about some of those projects moving forward. So just to give you some stats on West Henderson, when we did our land use planning for West Henderson, we established land uses, we established roadways, and then we projected what our populations would be. Essentially, West Henderson is 12,600 acres, 7,300 acres of that are developable land. There are currently 5,000 units out in West Henderson. That, a lot of that includes the Inspirata development that you see going up. Some of you may live there. We estimate 28,500 dwelling units at build out over 30 years in all of West Henderson. The current population is about 12,600, which is 20% of the expected build-out population of West Henderson of 63,500 people. There is 1.7 million square feet of commercial space, which is less than half of what is ultimately expected to build out, and we'll talk about some of those projects that are going to make up some of that square footage. There's a lot of industrial and office square footage that you see being built in West Henderson right now, approximately 200,000 square feet. Yeah. of office, but as much as 7 million square feet is anticipated. One of our goals in West Henderson is to drive up the employment, and I know you've probably heard the mayor talk about that in other talks. Employment is important to us. We have a frontier in West Henderson, and so one of our goals is to drive up employment in West Henderson. Nearly one-third of the 7.5 million square feet of industrial development that is anticipated is already being built out in West Henderson. And this is about a 30-year plan, and that's about 60,000 employees. And as you can see, that's about 1-to-1 employee to resident ratio, which is an important ratio for us. It's one of our stats that we track. This is our land use plan, and I know it kind of looks like a patchwork quilt. I'm missing a slide, and so what I'll do is talk to you specifically about some of the balances out there. If you remember, I said, we have 12,600 acres of land in West Henderson, but only 7,300 of that is developable. It's very important to the city to preserve open spaces and parklands for our residents. As we've developed West, we've always had a master developer that's come in, whether it be Green Valley Ranch or Anthem or Seven Hills, do master planning for large acreages. We don't have that in West Henderson, absent Inspirata. And so it was important to us, to the city, to preserve some of our hillsides, to be sensitive to the Sloan Canyon National Recreation Area, and to preserve some of our natural washes out there. With that, I'm going to step aside and turn it over to Amy. She could talk about parks, and then I'll be back up after Tom.
Good morning. And again, if you cannot hear me, let me know, because I have allergies going on, so I apologize. My name is Amy Wojcik, and thank you, Michael. I work with Parks and Recreation, and my area we deal with, it's park planning, so we work with the design and construction of parks and trails within the city. And I will go ahead and switch to the next slide. So, as the mayor mentioned, we are working to have a goal of making sure we have parks and trails within a 10-minute walk of every residence. And then, as Michael said, yes, we are working on parks out in the West Henderson area. So as you can see from the slide, the green areas are all the proposed parks that we have out in the future for West Henderson. And this is based on, obviously, the proposed or anticipated population, as well as making sure we're trying to have that 5.5 acres per resident, as well as the 10-minute walk. So you can see we have, and actually I'll do my, so we have a park up here by the M Resort, and those are more of the, we actually have 10-acre parks, and then these are 10-acre parks, oops, right here, 10 acres. And then as we get farther south, we are going down to 5 acres, with the exception of what is considered, we call that mountain park right now, because as Michael had said, there's not areas that's not as developable. So this is, we're gonna take advantage of that as a park, because there is terrain that we are going to contend with on that one. Really the park area will be right in this area, and it'll be more so natural. This area, this park right here, is an 80 acre site. That is, we are going to see this as an area where we have a rec center, a police and fire facility, a possible library location as well. So this site will house a lot of facilities, as well as keep to our park area. This is another 50 acre park that we propose in the future. And then you can see the Inspirata parks that we have in the future. We have 3 new parks that will come out of West Henderson, Inspirata. And I guess that is it for the parks right now. So I will turn it over to Tom, who will speak roadways.
Good morning. Thank you, Amy. My name is Tom Davey. I'm the city traffic engineer. I'm the city engineer for the Public Works Department here at the City of Henderson. And like Michael was saying earlier, we have a master transportation plan that we work towards accomplishing roadway network, which is vital to the orderly development of West Henderson. There is one notation I'd like to show you on this. This alignment of Gillespie actually no longer veers off to the west. We're planning it to come straight down to the south along this alignment. And I noticed that after the slides were created. So as we go forward, just note that Gillespie is going to just run north and south along that alignment. So as part of the development of all the projects that Michael will be sharing with you later, it's incumbent on those developments to build their off-site improvements or roadway improvements that are associated with their development. So the projects that I'm going to be going over are what the city is doing in addition to what the development will be constructing as they move forward with their projects. Right now, a lot of you may or may not use this portion of St. Rose Parkway near Executive Airport. There's a left-hand turn lane there that gets extremely long during the peak hours of travel. So right now we have a design consultant that is going to be performing some intersection improvements there, which also include a dual left turn lane, which will get more cars through that intersection during the peak hours and minimize the delay that motorists are experiencing in that location. Bermuda Road, between St. Rose Parkway and Volunteer. Currently there's a lot of activity happening here, both in an industrial development, as well as a charter school that Michael will tell you a little bit more about later. So having multiple ways in and out of West Henderson was identified as a key need. In response to that, we're utilizing the FR fuel revenue indexing dollars that the RTC manages that the voters approved in 2016 to construct this segment of Bermuda Road. It's currently advertised. I think we opened bids, construction bids, this week. We plan on beginning construction early July or August of this year, and hope to have the road open and operational early part of 2021. It'll be two travel lanes in each direction, with with room for future expansion, as well as bicycle facilities. Sunridge Heights Parkway, Costco, everybody's probably familiar with that, is right in this area here. Right now, the original plan was to build Sunridge Heights as a single phase project. The way design and construction goes, there's always unexpected things that we're dealing with, so timing isn't always work out in our favor. So we ended up phasing the project as into phase one, phase two, and phase three. So right now, under construction is phase one. It'll make this linkage between Seven Hills Parkway and St. Rose Parkway, and it'll give residents and possibly Costco patrons an alternate way out to St. Rose Parkway. Like I said, that project is currently under construction. We should be done early to mid-summer, and that roadway will be open and available for use. Phase two, right now we're dealing with property owners along that corridor in obtaining the rights of way to be able to build that portion of the roadway. That too will be two lanes in each direction with bicycle facilities. And the goal of St. Rose Parkway, or Sunridge Heights Parkway, excuse me, is to take some of the travel demand off of St. Rose Parkway and give motorists an alternative to get to some of the commercial developments that'll be at the Costco, I forget the name of the St. Rose Square. There's going to be several commercial developments in there, and this will give a motorist an alternate way of getting in and out of there without having to go out to St. Rose Parkway. We also have phase three. The first quarter mile of this road is also currently advertising. There'll be a traffic signal installed here. That might not be popular with everybody, but the needs of the traffic demands that are forecasted for this area requires for safety a traffic signal here. We're building about the first quarter mile of this road. That is currently under design, or is advertising, and will be constructed later this summer and should be open for public use early 2021. Via Nobila. This is part of that backbone network that's going to serve the entire West Henderson area. And again, Gillespie is going to come down this alignment here versus veering off to the west. This is approximately 2.5 miles of roadway that'll link Via Inspirata to Las Vegas Boulevard. It's part of the design. We're designing waterline facilities, sewer facilities, flood control facilities that'll aid water, storm water to cross beneath the road. We're anticipating some of the natural washes to remain in that fashion, natural, with some trails integrated in there. So we're planning on doing some grade-separated pedestrian crossings there to aid in the recreation when you're utilizing those trails that are planned for that area. The design is just kicking off now. We are anticipating about a 12-month design period because of the complex needs of that design, with construction starting in 2020 and to be completed in 2021. Eastern Avenue Corridor. I'm sure everybody's driven on Eastern Avenue Corridor. It's frustrating at times just due to the traffic. The good news is, with all the network of the roadways being constructed to the west of here, we've seen a drop in average daily traffic volumes on Eastern Avenue from approximately 76,000 cars per day to 52,000 vehicles per day. But that 52,000 vehicles per day, we're looking for a more efficient way to manage them, and that is the purpose of this study. We're looking at some potential reconfigurations of intersection, what we refer to as access control. We don't want to eliminate access to the businesses and things that people use Eastern for, but we want to make them more efficient so they won't interfere with the main flow on Eastern Avenue. We're even considering doing some grade separated structure right at St. Rose to get people through that intersection more quickly. That's going to require coordination with NDOT, because St. Rose is an NDOT managed corridor. Right now there is a need for some immediate repair on Eastern Avenue, essentially from St. Rose South to roughly Horizon Ridge Drive. We are currently have in design a project to address that dilapidated piece of road. There's potholes, there's open grade, what's the technical term is, it's delaminating from the roadway and just, it has a rough ride. So that project is currently under design. We should have that out to bid late summer, early fall of this year, so we can do some of that rehabilitation work and not wait for the results of the feasibility of the corridor study to be complete before we do any kind of maintenance on that road. Also included in that project is this little piece of Jeffries. Right now there's a what we call referred to as a sawtooth, a narrowing of the roadway. There, the city owns this property here that we're planning to put a park on it sometime in the future. But we're going to widen the east half of the roadway there to two lanes, so it doesn't narrow down to a single lane. And there's some rehabilitation needs along Jeffrey that we'll be addressing. We're aware that there's rehabilitation needs, you know, all over Henderson, so we're addressing them. We're trying to target the most critical needs early on. So bear with us. There's lots of orange cones in your future. I-215, which has recently been handed over from Clark County to NDOT. NDOT is ultimately going to manage this corridor, but in the interim, it's still being developed, improved by Clark County Public Works. This stretch, this is being Stephanie Street here, all the way to Windmill Parkway here. The portion of the road that's denoted in the green is currently being redesigned to add a lane in each direction. Sounds pretty simple. Sounds like we just throw some stripes on the road and put one more lane in each direction, but it's not the case. There's five bridges in here that are going to require modification to accomplish this, to provide the width that we need to be able to accommodate more traffic. That project is being managed by Clark County Public Works. They're finalizing design. We should have a bid package out this summer for construction, and then shortly after that construction will begin. It'll probably be up to a 12-month long project, but the good news is it'll move traffic a lot smoother through here once it's complete. This gold portion is also something that the Clark County Public Works Department is planning to widen in the future. They don't have any consultant under contract right now to design that, but that's forthcoming. And then finally, the Henderson Interchange. This is an interchange that Henderson identified as needing immediate attention. So what we have done is initiated a feasibility study with which Henderson is funding. Granted, this is a NDOT corridor and a Clark County corridor, but we quite frankly didn't want to wait for them to start the feasibility study. So we initiated a feasibility study. back in December of last year, which is approximately 25% complete now. And what we're looking at is some alternatives to improve this interchange. And everybody, I'm sure, has had their share of frustration going through this interchange. So right now where we're at in that feasibility study is we're identifying potential alternatives that can accomplish what we need done. We're looking at traffic volumes out to the 2040 timeframe that these improvements would be able to accommodate. So once we complete that feasibility study, which is scheduled to conclude at the end of this year, we're working alongside NDOT with this. They've been a partner of ours during this design and coordinating with them. And we'll hand off the deliverable that we're getting out of our feasibility study to NDOT, and they'll start what's referred to as the NEPA process. It's a National Environmental Policy Act. It's the environmental phase of getting this interchange approved by the federal government. When we use federal funds, this is a necessary part of the process. The current administration has taken some steps to reduce the length of time that this federal environmental process would take, and they're making representations that we can have that portion of the project done within a 2-year time frame. So the NDOT will ultimately be constructing the improvements that are needed at that interchange. So that is all I have with regards to roadways. I'll hand it back over to Michael Cassie.
So as you can see, there has been a lot of work from the city of Henderson looking at West Henderson to accommodate the development that I'm about to go through. I did want to mention a couple of things, and if I could brag a little bit for parks. They have a plan for the natural drainage ways in West Henderson to remain natural, and they plan parks that go all up, so there's trails within those natural drainage ways, and they have parks that connect along those drainage ways as well. So we're interested in preserving the natural desert environment out there, and I think that's a great plan from Parks perspective. And I don't know if anybody has driven this Via Inspirata Road that is now under construction. It's there's some significant terrain back there, so it did take some planning on the public works side to get it through, but it looks great. It's a great looking road, and it's kind of a cool drive through the desert there. So what I'd like to do is start walking through some of the proposed developments and developments that are under construction in West Henderson. So this map represents everything that you see blue hatched. The number of developments in West Henderson that are either approved or are in the process of being approved in the city. What this doesn't have are all the other projects that we've had conversations about, but we haven't seen applications yet. So there's a lot more going on, but I wanted to try and spend some time walking through some of these projects. First of all, I'll start with Rose Ridge. This is a Lennar home single family development, 394 units. It's being constructed right now. This is along Sun Ridge Heights near Wolf Elementary School and along, I believe that is Upper Center Drive. So that one is well underway. It's been under construction for some time now. Next to that is the Empire Apartments by Nevada West Partners. It's 536 units. These are the three-story red buildings right there on the corner of St. Rose Parkway. Those are under construction. You can see there is the plan. It's one of those, it's a highly amenitized apartment development. So they've got a lot of amenities available for their future residents. We have what is called the Village by Stable Development. This is 550,000 square feet of medical office, professional, and retail. So this is a mixed use development on 12.5 acres that'll include restaurants, it'll include a coffee shop, it has a marijuana dispensary. This is the plan. You can see they've got some 4- and 5-story buildings as part of their proposed development, and this is what the building looks like. So you can see it's got some height, it's got some parking underneath along with the office and the retail. So I'll keep moving on, and then like I said, save your questions. I'll be happy to talk about some of these projects in more detail. Rosemary Plaza, this is right next to the Costco. It's 21 acres, 238,000 square feet. It's still pending. Denley Investments out of Beverly Hills, and they've kind of stalled, so we're not sure where they're at with this project, but it is one of those that we have on our docket. So this is a typical shopping center retail. They don't have any anchors identified, which is probably why they're not moving forward at this time. Then, of course, St. Rose Square, Costco, as everybody knows, this one is under construction. You can see here, this is their overall site plan. Costco is built. I believe there's a Popeyes out there. We have approvals for an In-N-Out Burger. And then this center piece here, do I have a laser pointer? Yeah, I do. This center right here is under construction, and that is more of a urban feel development that's right up to the roadway. Ovation Development, this is Alan Molaski's apartments right next to Elise Elementary and next to one of our parks out in West Henderson. This is 286 units on 11.2 acres. This is similar to a project that's right down here on Paseo Verde. It's that same Class A level apartment development. We have, as you go up and down Executive Airport, you can see there's a number of industrial developments being built. There are some that are finishing construction. Air Park South has 212,000 square feet of industrial development, much of which that is constructed right now. Retco Group, this is 53,000-ish acres, or I'm sorry, square feet of more industrial development. So this is, when I talked about trying to drive up the employment numbers in West Henderson, this is what gets us that space. It's what our economic development group uses to try and attract some companies into Henderson. Even at the airport, there are a couple of hangar buildings that are being constructed. That's not a real good plan, but you can imagine hangars, they all kind of look alike. Nevada West Partners is also building apartments at the corner of Star and St. Rose. So just for some context, right here is Levi's. So this is, again, it's highly amenitized. You can see they have a couple of pool areas and a number of different amenities for their residents. That one is 380 units on 17 acres. Lennar Homes, so this is the piece that we call the pizza pie, and you'll see why in a second. It's a 306 lots, varied sizes, 41 acres. It's both single family detached, a couple of different products, and single family attached. It's got a pizza shape, so that's why we called it that. But all this single family attached product here is on the frontage of St. Rose, and then they have a variety of single family detached products behind that. Moving on. I'll try not to geek out being a Raider fan, but the Raiders headquarters is well under construction. I don't know if you've driven by there lately. Right now, the field house is going up under construction. You can see the height of that building. It's about 110 feet. There's a field and a half inside, and there are three fields outside, along with their headquarters and offices that are framed up right now. They anticipate getting into that building in the summer of 2020 before they relocate here. So they're moving along quickly. And that's just kind of the elevation they've submitted to us. This is what it's going to look like eventually. So Matter at West Henderson, which is right next to the Raiders development. This is about 17 acres, 300,000 square feet. This is flex office and retail with a tavern. All of this back here, this is single story retail frontages. They're under construction. I think they got their grading permit within the last couple of weeks. Toronto Bakery is existing. It's their first phase is about 100,000 square feet on 5 acres. This is the piece that they've developed already. They have future phases as possible development for future, depending on their growth. This is basically what the building looks like. So as you can tell, we're moving up and down Executive Airport. One of the projects you may have heard about in the news last year is called, it's Henderson West. It's by Savage Development. I think the news media referred to it as the block. It's 110 acres, about 2,900 units. They're still working through their plans. They've submitted a new master plan to us just last week. This is what that looks like. Here is St. Rose Parkway. They have a retail frontage along St. Rose. They've got some detached housing and attached housing product on this side. These are apartments all surrounding a amenitized 4-acre park that's going to be privately developed. This one, they want to get moving pretty quickly, so we're in the negotiation process with them right now. Gillespie multifamily moving down St. Rose towards Zam Resort. This one is under construction, 340 units on 20 acres. This is Gillespie as it comes from St. Rose up here. And again, the same sort of development from Nevada West. It's highly amenitized with several pools for their residents. Project Hope, this is a distribution facility in West Henderson, 600,000 square feet. It's a large development. I don't know that I can tell you who is going in there, but you might be able to suspect by what the colors are. They got grading permits last week. They'll be under construction soon. Tom had mentioned the Pinecrest Academy at Sloan Canyon. This is the new charter school that is going to be K-12, and at ultimate build-out will be about 2,400 students. This one is under construction, if you've seen it there along Volunteer. They've got a soccer field, and they've got their buildings under construction right now. I believe they're starting first phase K-8, and then they'll add the high school as they progress over the years. My understanding is they intend to be open by fall of next year. Volunteer Marketplace, this is a recent development, 6,500 square feet of restaurants, a tavern, retail, a convenience store. This is between Gillespie and Placid. They haven't started construction yet. This is a vignette of what they'll look like, but this is basically right behind the D.R. Horton development that is existing out in West Henderson, this being Volunteer. So that's a little bit closer up of what those buildings are going to look like. Speaking of the D.R. Horton active adult development, this which is right behind the one I just spoke of, this is 75 lots on 15 acres. They continue to develop in here. This has been going on for, I think, about a year now. Roberts Communications, there are some office buildings, so the development we were just talking about, that's D.R. Horton. This is where Roberts Communications is. There's two office buildings and a telecom maintenance building. Basically, what these guys do, you can see there's a antenna array fields. They have satellite dishes, and they broadcast events to sports books here in Nevada. So they're going to... I believe they have one or two functioning satellite dishes right now, but they're going to increase their output over time. You may have heard about Haas Automation. This is in our South LTA. So this is moving down via Inspirata and Executive Airport. Inspirata single family development is over here. Haas is about 2.4 million square feet of manufacturing. Haas Automation, if you're not familiar, they make the machines that make the machines. And so they're a worldwide company, and we're very, very happy to have them, 2,500 employees at their final build out. But this is their first phase, and it's 2.4 million square feet, which that's a pretty significant building. Into the Inspirata Town Center, for those of you who are familiar with the Inspirata Villages, these are the homes that are built out there, the master plan community. Just to the west of that is what we call the Inspirata Town Center that was under separate ownership, and until recently we haven't seen development. So now we're starting to see a lot of proposals. In fact, we had three coming through. We have two going to Planning Commission this Thursday, and we had one go through City Council in April. But we did have a Inspirata Stations Casino that has been proposed out there for a number of years. They have entitlements. Our understanding is that this is still an important part of their portfolio. We just don't know what their timeline for development is. The Party Homes development out in the Inspirata Town Center, 225 lots, 23 acres. It's both single family attached and single family detached. If you're familiar, this is Bicentennial. This is what they call the Outlook. And so the Inspirata Village is over here. This development sits right here. I'll be talking about this one here in a moment. But if you're familiar with what Party Homes does out in Inspirata, it's a very similar product, with the exception of the newly They don't have an attached product in this market, but they're bringing one in here for us. This is an example of the architecture that they had approved for that development. You can see it's contemporary, and they do have some modern farmhouse architecture. Distill Tavern, this is on along via Inspirata. This is a Remedies, so this got approved last year. They're going to be under construction soon. You have the Inspirata Marketplace. I had just mentioned that. So this is a unique development. If you're familiar with the roundabout that's out here, here's Bicentennial. You know the roadway splits on either side of that of this median. Well, that is zoned commercial, and it was owned privately. And so what they proposed, this is one way, this is the other way. So it was a complex traffic solution for us. They have a C-store and retail with some restaurants proposed in the median of a large roadway. So this is gonna have some very, you know, I'm a planner, cool amenities out there. So their walls aren't gonna be walls. There'll be some metal fencing that's highly sculptural. So that's what we were trying to drive out in the Inspirata Town Center as a higher level of architecture. Bicentennial Marketplace, I had just spoken about the party development, which is right here. This is the overlook. This is the same developer for that piece. It's the same owner. There is a proposed tavern with some restaurants and some outdoor eating areas, along with some retail right at that corner of Bicentennial, and I believe this is Via Contessa. And so with that, that's a lot of developments happening in West Henderson. So we're here and available to answer any questions you might have. I'll turn it back to the mayor.
Thank you very much, Michael, and to our presenters. We appreciate your feedback, and we're going to be asking and opening it up to questions now. Just to share with you, quality community doesn't happen by chance. It's very thoughtful and deliberate. And in Henderson, several years ago, we adopted the Henderson Strong Plan, and then subsequently the West Henderson Plan. And so the decisions that have been made, whether it's in planning or public works or parks, has all been deliberate and following a plan to ensure the quality of life that our residents have come to enjoy and appreciate. And our commitment is to have a park or a trail within a mile, and hopefully at some point within a half a mile of every home, because we know how important that quality of life is to our residents, and we want to ensure that quality of life into the future for the folks who live here. And we're also very deliberate about how we manage the city and using its resources and financially. We actually are a AA+ bond rated city, and we have strong reserves, and we're very conscious about how we run this city. So quality of life is very important to us, and we know that it's very important to you. At this time, I'd like to open up to questions about West Henderson and about the things that are going on in the West Henderson area. Yes, Cyrus?
Yeah, my question.
Cyrus, in fact, there should be a microphone somewhere that maybe you could speak in. Sure.
One of the concerns I have is that I feel like that this does not, I could be wrong, adapt to future trends. We're seeing retail demand decline. The Sears just closed by the Galleria, and I project that retail will continue to decline. Parking lot use will decline because of rideshare programs, and we're seeing new transit systems. I was at the LVCVA meeting. They're talking about the People Mover system, how they're gonna connect the Strip, Convention. I told them to extend that system to the outer fringe part of the valley, which includes West Henderson. So hopefully you guys can prepare about that. And the other comment I wanna make is there are plans in the West Henderson area to include areas of mixed use areas where you live in a single family home, and then you walk across the street, and then there is a building that looks like a villa with a shop on the bottom and a condo or an office above, so that we reduce the need of a car and we build an area with a lot of character.
You know, I can tell you that the city of Henderson is very mindful of quality construction and ensuring different product types occur in different areas. And you talk about transit and transportation. As vice chair of the RTC, I'm mindful of that as well. But you have urban centers where there's more density that allows for those creative transit solutions to happen earlier in the development process. And there has to be development that follows. So as we get more densities in the outlying areas, I can see solutions, transit solutions, being part of that equation for the future for our community.
So just a quick response. So it's possible in a few years, I can or someone buy some land and build just what I was talking about?
Oh, certainly. I think that we have developers approaching us on different product types. In fact, Michael, you could probably talk about some of the creative approaches we're seeing.
So we do have that type of mixed-use development. The Henderson West project that I mentioned, their hope is to have some of that sort of development where it's an apartment wrap or it's a ground floor retail with residential above. That's something that our West Henderson plan and our development code encourage, that sort of development. And we provide the flexibility for developers to address market conditions as they're developing.
And single family homes next to it, so even they don't have to rely on cars.
You know, the whole West Henderson plan and all of our planning is done around walkability in part and parcel with our Parks and Rec department. So walkability is important to us in Henderson, and our connections between our neighborhoods and the services that they use are also important. So those walkways, those connections, whether they be roadway, pedestrian, or bike, that's something that is a goal of ours, yes.
Thank you.
Other questions? Comment? Yes, sir.
You only mentioned one school out in the area, so what's the plans for education? And that's a charter school.
There is one charter school under construction. We do have, in the West Henderson plan, when we as a city looked at the entirety of the 12,000 acres and we estimated the population, we worked with the school district and with other schools to identify where those future schools would be. There's a school under construction in Inspirata. There's a charter school in Inspirata that's been open for I think a couple years now, and there are two additional schools in Inspirata that are identified for future CCSD schools. And that's not to mention we've got a high school that we've located. We've got another elementary school, a middle school site. So we did look at the 63,500 population. We use a number and says it's going to be this many students. And so we worked with the school district to identify where those school locations would be. So we do have a school district.
Again, that comes back to the deliberate planning of our West Henderson area, that with our Henderson Strong plan and with the West Henderson plan, we made sure that we worked with all of our partners, whether it was the Clark County School District or the Water Authority or the various agencies and Nevada Power and others, to work to make sure that we have a thoughtful, deliberate plan for how we build out the West Henderson area. Yes. I'm not sure what the school district's plan on that is. I know in terms of charter schools, I think that there's that construction of the one on Volunteer, but in terms of the Clark County School District, some of that is the bonding process that has to go through the Clark County School District and the approval for those sites. So that's not really in our hands. That decision isn't in our hands. However, it's as important to us as it is to you.
In any of that development, is there plans for low-income housing?
Yes, I believe. In fact, we're working with Nevada Hand and others and looking at working with the market-rate developers to include some housing in their development.
Affordable housing is the low-income housing, I think that has kind of a misnomer to it. So when we're talking about housing that's affordable to a wide variety of people, that's our goal. And so to drive that goal, we want a variety of housing products. So whether that be apartments or attached homes, single family detached, different types of single family detached homes, those are all part of what we're doing in West Henderson. We are also partnering with some of our developers to try and identify some of those more affordable homes within their market rate developments. That way we have, Henderson wants to be welcoming to all people. And so the only way we can do that is provide a wide variety of housing products that's affordable for all levels.
I wanted to ask about when you develop new roads or looking at expansion of the roads, for example, St. Rose Parkway, we're going to have all these additional buildings, we're going to have people entering and exit. We don't have that many traffic signals right now. The speed limit's 55, but as the police know, people are going faster than 55. Are you also look?
The police said no.
I didn't say the mayor was going faster than 55. Are you looking at those factors and making appropriate changes?
Yes, and in fact, we'll have our engineer come up. We're very mindful of the changes that occur, maybe traffic conditions that occurred on Eastern 5 years ago, or even 10 years ago, led to, say, having Bicentennial and some other roads built. So we make a lot of decision based on changing trends and circumstances, and our engineers are constantly monitoring roads and road conditions. So I'll let Tom speak to that.
In specific to St. Rose Parkway, in the presentation I gave, it was, and I don't know, I'm sorry. That was the purpose of the Sunridge Heights alignment, was to take some of that traffic off that higher speed St. Rose Parkway and put it on more of a local arterial to give motorists and people utilizing those businesses a safer, slower speed option versus coming in and off of St. Rose Parkway. And St. Rose Parkway is actually under the jurisdiction of NDOT, and NDOT is very restrictive about how many driveways they allow in and off of their highway. So there's plans in place to minimize how much of that interaction occurs.
How about the gridlock problem on eastbound St. Rose and Paseo Verde, where gridlocks every day?
I'm referring to from Eastern going eastbound to Paseo Verde, Coronado Center, where it gridlocks, where everyone's trained. It's only one lane going on to the 215, and everybody's the last minute merging approach to resolving that problem, because I noticed that wasn't mentioned. Also, one other thing. One of the things that seems to cause a lot of gridlock is the automation system for the traffic signals when EMS response goes through the intersection. Those traffic signal lights do not know when the last cycle was. So for example, it'll reset. So if your turn was up next to go green, if you know I drive a school bus, so I deal with this on an everyday basis, and we have a schedule to meet too, where after that emergency vehicle passes through, the lights reset back over and the traffic just builds up on all sections like Eastern and St. Rose. Developing a smart system where those traffic lights can remember the last setting that was at, so that it can manage that traffic and doesn't cause a gridlock. Because almost every time, St. Rose Dominican Hospital, if a paramedic unit or fire department unit is heading there, that whole Eastern going up to Horizon Ridge will back up and going all the way down to Silverado Ranch in the opposite way. So I just thought I'd address that as well.
I'll go ahead and tackle the first question. And I know I introduced myself as a traffic engineer, but that's not the case. So I'll hand it off to Alyssa. We are planning a study and bringing a consultant on board for the Pecos 215 interchange there to make that more efficient. We're going to initiate studies at that interchange, as well as Green Valley Parkway, Eastern, and then way out by the State College. So those are on our radar screen. I didn't include them as part of the presentation, but those are projects that we're currently in the planning stages and in the process of hiring a consultant to help us decide how best to deal with that. It's going to take some time. I know we need it now, but it'll start with feasibility studies right away.
Every day.
Yeah, and we're aware of that. And again, it's Clark County and NDOT that are ultimately being control of that, and similar to the Henderson interchange, we don't want to wait. So we're starting that process now. Otherwise, we'd be waiting at the county and NDOT for these problems to arise.
And just really quick, my name is Alyssa Rodriguez. I'm the Assistant Director of Public Works, but in my former life, I was the city traffic engineer. We do have a system of preemption for the emergency vehicles at all of the City of Henderson lights. They are GPS-based. We're the only ones in the valley that are utilizing the system. And one of the things that it's given us is many life-saving seconds that gets those emergency vehicles through those traffic signals. We did some testing with our previous system and the new system, and it's a dramatic difference. Now, that being said, it does interrupt the coordination of the traffic signal system. So, you know, everybody gets their turn at a traffic signal, and then all the signals are coordinated all the way down the line. So you can imagine if we completely interrupt that and we allow one movement to pass through when it wasn't planned to do so, it takes a little while to get around through the circulation. So we're aware of that. However, we feel that the ability to get our emergency vehicles through those traffic signals in a much faster fashion is really important. And even though it does take a few seconds to tick around and get back to your turn, we feel that this is really important.
Thank you, Alyssa. Any other questions? Yes.
With Orchestra Bermuda becoming two lanes in each direction,
I was wondering what the impact on the Lion Habitat Ranch is going to be.
The Lion Habitat, Bermuda and St. Rose? What's going to
happen? It's Bermuda and Verona.
Bermuda and Verona.
If you're speaking about Bermuda in specific, we have all the right of way and it's not going to encroach into that particular. Yeah.
Thank you. Yes, there's a question in the back.
Hi, I live in Inspirada, and in the morning time for Pinecrest School children, it's just traffic jam getting in and out of our community. And even if we take the back way to go to Las Vegas, there is a one way from in there to Las Vegas, to Inspirada. And if the trucks or tractors are on that lane, you cannot pass through, so it makes it longer. So with all the developing that's going on, are they going to open up more roads, lanes, more exits?
I think what we heard from the engineer was that there are more roads planned in that area, which will help to relieve that West Henderson area. You know, we know that at every school site, in the morning and in the evening, we do have some traffic challenges. And I'm not sure that there's any simple solution during the school start hours and the finish hours at the end of the day. So there's always going to be some traffic challenges. But certainly we could take a look at that area and see if there's something more that can be done to make sure that the traffic flow is smoother for you. Any other questions or comments? Sure.
Yes. I have two roadway questions. Do you know if the new Star Avenue, where Airport I think now turns into Star on the other side of St. Rose, I noticed there's an interchange going up on I-15 that says Star. That'll connect.
Yes.
So that'll be good.
Yes.
And then Bicentennial, I thought Bicentennial was supposed to eventually go through to Las Vegas Boulevard, but squinting at those maps, I couldn't see that going through. I couldn't really read that. And follow on to that, is there some place where I don't have to squint at those maps, where I can actually see those?
We have on the city's website, you go to cityhenderson.com and you go into community development, there's maps in there where you can actually bring that particular map up.
And they're legible.
And they're legible. And I was kind of, there's a lot going on there. But that whole backbone, it's called our master transportation plan. It has all the arterial, the large width roadways that we're planning for that area to alleviate the traffic congestion issues that come with development.
And Bicentennial?
You know what, I can't remember exactly how.
Next to Gillespie.
Bicentennial will run in the same alignment and it'll connect to Gillespie, which won't go as far as Las Vegas Boulevard. Gillespie is the first North South Street east of Las Vegas.
On the other side of the alley, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But Democracy goes through.
Democracy. That one map.
Sorry, I should just stand up here. Democracy will continue west until it reaches Gillespie, then it will go north. Then you'll have access to the Via Inspirada, Via Novila, and the St. Rose interchanges to get out to the 215. So you'll have a number of ways to connect.
Okay, so Democracy going through Gillespie, not Bicentennial?
Oh, I misunderstand. Bicentennial, I'm sorry. Bicentennial will connect up to Via Inspirada. And then that becomes, it stops there. That's correct.
Yeah, I had understood it was going to go through. So, okay. Yeah, so
it's trying to be in Inspirada to go west and towards. And then here's Democracy, and that'll make a connection. This is Bermuda. So,
and that the one in the middle is Novila, is that?
This is the one that's currently under design. So there, this is the VA Inspirada East-West connection. This is the one that we currently have under design. This is about
Boulevard is currently being constructed?
It's completed.
Yes.
We'll take one more question. Can you tell me what's going on with Henderson Pavilion, the cover?
Yeah, who would like to, we're going to be rebuilding it, and I think it's going to be more of a permanent structure on top. It won't be the soft material that we've ended up having to replace twice. It will be a hard cover. And that's, maybe Rob, you could answer that, what the timeline on that is, and when we'll be putting that out.
Hi, Robert Herr, Assistant City Manager. We've looked at several options. How can we maybe enclose that and protect it from the elements, but that obviously increases the cost. So we are looking at options of just replacing the cover. That can get up to $10 million because it's now out of code, so we have to do a lot of changes to the structure itself and then come back with the canopy. And if we're going to make that kind of investment, maybe we ought to make a little more investment and enclose it and keep it out of, it also would extend the season for us. So we're looking at those options. We haven't landed on one yet, but we're getting really close because we do want to get that back in operation, get that protection from the sun, and do the right thing there.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I just wanted to point out to you that our next monthly get-together is going to be called the Council Connections, and one of our councilmen will actually be presenting up in Sun City Anthem on June 19th at 6 in the evening. So I'd like to encourage you, if you want to hear about what's going on in Ward 2, to attend that meeting as well. So thank you very much for joining us today, and thanks to our wonderful staff for their presentation. And please stick around. We have plenty of staff here, so if you have questions, stick around and ask our staff what's what your concern.